Dear children, come back to online classes. Today we are going to see chapter number 1 of civics, that is the Indian Constitution. So let me first explain you what is a constitution. A constitution is primarily a set of rules and principles specifying how a country should be governed, how power is distributed and controlled, and what rights citizens possess. So why does a country need a constitution? A constitution is necessary because of the following reasons. It is an important law of the land. It determines the relationship of the citizens within the governments. It lays down principles and guidelines which are required for people belonging to different ethnic and religious groups to live in harmony. So now let us take the example of Nepal. Once Nepal was a monarchy. So people movement in Nepal fought for several decades to establish democracy in Nepal. And in 2006, finally, they succeeded in putting an end to the power of the king. And now the people have to write a new constitution to establish Nepal as a democracy. The reason that they do not want to continue with the previous constitution is because it does not reflect the ideas of the country that they want Nepal to be and they have fought for. So as in the game of football, in which a change in the constitutive rules will change the game altogether, like that Nepal, by moving from a monarchy to a democratic government, need to change all its constitutive rules. So the second important purpose of a constitution is to define the nature of country's political system. That is, children, let me explain you what would happen if there were no restriction on the power of elected representatives. We elect leaders so that they can exercise power, responsibility on our behalf. However, there is always the possibility that these leaders might misuse their authority, and the constitution usually provides safeguards against this. So this misuse of authority can result in a gross injustice. So that is why there should be a restriction on the power of elected leaders. And the next thing here, another important function that a constitution plays in democracy is to ensure that a dominant group does not use its power against other less powerful people or groups. So let us see the storyboard and I'll be explaining you. In a class, there are two groups, girls and boys. So here the number of boys are more in number. So they want to play cricket and their decision was final here. So they are dominating the less powerful people. Like in the storyboard, boys dominated the girls. So such unhealthy situation can occur in democratic societies too, where a majority can continuously enforce decision that exclude minorities and go against their interest. So another reason why we have a constitution is precisely to prevent this tyranny or domination by the majority of a minority. This can refer to one community dominating another, that is inter-community domination, or members of one community dominating others within the same community, that is intra-community domination. Now let us see the key features of the Indian Constitution. तो फर्स्ट इज फेडरलिज्म. व्हाट इज फेडरलिज्म? फेडरलिज्म रिफर्स टू द एक्सिस्टेंस ऑफ मोर देन वन लेवल ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इन द कंट्री. इन इंडिया वी हैव गवर्नमेंट एट द स्टेट लेवल एंड एट द सेंटर. द पंचायती राज इज द थर्ड टायर ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. So this